things shaping up, a lot of things happening. Let's get into our show for tonight. The first thing I wanted to cover, I want to cover just a couple of light things, just to you know, do my thing like I like to do, is break the ice and see if I can piss people off right at the beginning of the show. I got this off the Yahoo Sports website. It's an article written by Jay Busby, Monday, March 22nd. The title of the article is, "What Was the Story with Tiger's Buddhism Bracelet?" Yeah, everybody's concerned about good old Tiger Woods, a man who can't keep his pants zipped up and earns $50, $60, $70 million a year doing it, just for doing a simple game, playing a simple game like golf. Now, golf is a simple game. It's not an easy game. I've tried to play golf. I'm a hacker. Gave it up years ago because it's frustrating, just like tennis. Just never could get the hang of it. But to pay people this kind of money to do this kind of thing, to me, it's just totally beyond ridiculousness. And now that this guy's, you know, can't seem to, got an addiction problem, sexual addiction problem, I'll give him the benefit of the doubt with that. You know, whatever. But the whole point of it being is that everything going on, and everybody's worried about whether Tiger Woods is going to make a comeback at the Masters, you know, whether he's going to be accepted back, how people are going to respond to him, this, that, and the other. But obviously, it was really important to this particular writer about recognizing that he had on a Buddhism bracelet. And it says, at the end of the Sunday night's golf channel, I guess this was back around March 22nd, with Tiger Woods, interviewer Kelly Tilghman made note of the bracelet Woods wore on his left wrist. From the official transcript, "I notice you're wearing a bracelet. Can we see it?" "Yeah." "What does it mean?" "It's Buddhist. It's for protection and strength, and I certainly need that." "When did you start wearing it?" "Before I went into treatment." "Will you be wearing it during the Masters?" "Absolutely." "For the rest of your life?" "Absolutely." Yep. The bracelet's going to help old Tiger Woods keep his pants zipped up. The bracelet isn't the big deal. You can pick up one of those at a mall for $5. It's what the bracelet represents, the idea of remembering one's core values, that makes it significant. Well, if Tiger Woods is going to be remembering his core values, then he's going to be wearing a lot of bracelets, because obviously his core values is that I'm a star, I am the male version of the diva, and I can do whatever the hell I want to do with whoever the hell I want to do it with, and you people have to accept that. Don't tell me for 1 minute that this guy is sorry about what he did. He's like Bill Clinton. He's sorry he got caught. And he's sorry about all the money he's lost because of it. He's sorry how it's affected his career. But I don't believe people like this have any understanding of what it is they're really doing wrong. The only reason they're doing it wrong is because they see a lot of people in the room upset at them, and they want to please everybody or whatever. So I wanted to get that right out in the open here, because I think this kind of stuff, the way we treat athletes today, you know, they make millions and millions of dollars, and none of them have an ounce of class. They have no dignity, no integrity. They think they can do whatever they want. They got their bling, they got their money, they got their girls, they got all this other stuff. And we are supposed to sit on the sidelines and continue to support these things. It's why I don't go to games, professional games. It's why I don't buy pay-per-view. I don't do any of this stuff, because these people get paid way too much money to do what most of us did as kids for free. And that's just what I think about that. So, next article here. This one's going to crack you up in a way. It definitely cracked me up. Written by Michael Tarm, Tuesday, March 23rd, Associated Press. ACORN disbanding because of money woes scandal. The Chicago. This is out of Chicago, good old Obama town. The once mighty community activist group, ACORN, announced Monday it is folding amid falling revenues 6 months after video footage emerged showing some of its workers giving tips to conservative activists posing as a pimp and prostitute. It's really declining revenue in the face of a series of attacks from partisan operatives and right-wing activists that have taken away our ability to raise the resources we need, ACORN spokesman Kevin Whelan said. Well, the resources you need came from the Czar Barack Obama and his cronies, and they can't be giving you money now because they can be tied to you. It's not the partisan operatives and the right-wing activists that did this. It was a man and a woman trying to make it into the field of journalism who did it. But of course, everything that brings the downfall of a Democrat or a liberal is the activist's fault. It's the right-wing activists, the partisan operatives, the Tea Party goers, and all this. We're the ones responsible for your lack of integrity. We're the ones responsible for your corruption and dishonesty. We're the ones responsible for you getting caught. Well, you know, there's an old saying, what goes around comes around, and everything comes out in a wash, and that's all that happened here. You guys got caught with your pants down, and now you're trying to blame somebody else for it. But my whole point of bringing this article up is not to just chastise these bastards, because that's what they need to be. They need to be chastised. They need to be marked. They need to be marked with red on them, you know, like sinner, like they used to do in the old days, where they put S on their chest and make them walk around so everybody knows what a low-life, bottom dweller they are. But here's the deal. If you think that these people are out of the picture, you're crazy. They're going to do what they've done before. So they've done this before. All they do is they regroup and they reorganize and they call it something different. ACORN is made up of 220 different organizations. 220 organizations that, by the way, received money from Barack Obama's stimulus plan. You'll remember the little scandal that broke right after that, where these people were getting pay raises and calling it saving jobs. These people will reorganize. What we're going to see is some of them are going to get hired probably as census workers and get paid 15 to 20 bucks an hour to go out and delve into our privacy and try to find out as much as they can about us so that they can control our lives even more. So some of them will probably end up doing that. Others will probably go into the Move On organization, Obama's mainstay organization that he's going to be activating here pretty quick as the socialist agenda begins to move on and try to use that organization to get out the propaganda that they need, that everything that he does is righteous and holy. And some of them may even join Obama in Washington and become part of his staff, as some of them already have. So all this stuff is going on. Don't think for one minute that this organization is dead. They are just reorganized, and they'll just come back at us in another form with another name. So, having said that, I'm going to go to my first break.